Hello friends, welcome to EC Academy.
In this lecture, we will understand NOR SR Latch. Latch is the basic storage element which can hold one bit of data. So if we consider SR Latch, there are two types of SR Latch, NOR Latch as well as the NAND Latch. In this lecture, we will understand NOR SR Latch. This is the logic circuit for NOR SR latch. So here inputs are S and R. So S specifies set, R specifies reset. Here output is Q and Q bar is the complement of the output. Now before going for the operation of NOR SR latch, let us see the truth table for NOR gate. For two inputs, we will be having four combinations 00, 01, 10 and 11. So output will be 1 when input are 00, and for remaining combinations output will be 0. So this is the truth table for NOR gate. Now let us see the working of SR latch. Let us take the first case where S is made as 0 and R is equal to 1. So S is equal to 0 and R is equal to 1. Now if we observe the truth table of NOR gate, output is 0, the output of NOR gate is 0 if any one input of NOR gate is 1. So if any one of the input is 1, or if the either of the input is 1, so the output is 0. For 0 0 output will be 1. Now let us use the same logic and we will analyze the working of SR latch. Since R is equal to 1, irrespective of what we get at other input, so Q will be equal to 0. Now this 0 will appear at this input, so 0 0 output is 1, so Q bar will be equal to 1. So we got the output as Q is equal to 0 and Q bar is equal to 1. Now if we take S is equal to 0 and R is equal to 0, so let us check for this condition. S is equal to 0 and R is equal to 0. So previous output of Q bar is 1. If this 1 will appear here, so 1 0 is output is 0, Q will be 0. So this 0 will appear here, so 0 0 output will be 1. So we got the same output. So for S is equal to 0 and R is equal to 0, we got Q is equal to 0 and Q bar is equal to 1. So that's why this state is known as memory state. Now let us make S is equal to 1 and R is equal to 0. Now S is equal to 1, R is equal to 0. Let us check the output. So since S is equal to 1, irrespective of whatever we get at this input, output will be equal to 0. So Q bar will be equal to 0. So this 0 will appear here. So 0 0, we know output is 1. So we got Q as 1 and Q bar as 0. Q will be 1 and Q bar will be equal to 0. Now let us take S is equal to 0 and R is equal to 0. So S is equal to 0, R is equal to 0. So the previous output Q bar was 0. So if this 0 appears here, so for 0 0 output will be 1. So Q will be having 1. And this 1 will appear here. So 1 0 output will be 0. So we will get the same state for Q and Q bar. So we got Q is equal to 1 and Q bar is equal to 0. That's why we will call this state where S is equal to 0 and R is equal to 0 as memory state. Now we will take the third case. S is equal to 1 and R is equal to 1. So let us find what is the output for S is equal to 1 and R is equal to 1. We know that if any one of the input is 1, output will be 0. Since R is equal to 1, Q will be equal to 0, and since S is equal to 1, Q bar will also be equal to 0. So we got Q is equal to 0 and Q bar is equal to 0. So if we observe the output, we got both the output as same. So this condition should not exist because Q bar is complement of Q. So this state is not valid. So that's why we'll call this state as invalid state. Now we can write the complete truth table for SR latch. So we can write S, R, output Q and Q bar. 00 01 10 11. So for 00 we got the memory state, we got the memory, which means the SR latch will give the previous output itself, and for 11 it is invalid state. So it is invalid state, and for S is equal to 0 and R is equal to 1, we got Q as 0 and Q bar as 1. And for S is equal to 1 and R is equal to 0, we got Q as 1, Q bar as 0. Hope you have understood this topic. Thank you.